When the Philippine government discovered that at least 200 Chinese vessels are already swarming the West Philippine Sea, and when maritime aerial patrols revealed just how developed the Chinese artificial islands are, the news team set out to find a group of people whose voices have yet to be heard. The Filipino fishermen, who now have to contend with this swarming on a daily basis. One of our stops was supposed to be Ayungin Shoal, where one of the 9 detachments of the Armed Forces of the Philippines is. Perhaps, we thought, Filipino fishermen would feel safe enough to anchor there and fish, knowing they were being protected. But just as we were approaching Ayungin Shoal, a white ship in the distance appeared to sail towards us. The crew watched for a while, hoping it was going on a different route. Minutes later, we heard them on the radio.
We were just about 4 miles to Ayungin Shoal, where the Philippine outpost is, and where there just might be Filipino fishermen docked there to do some fishing. But we got a radio call from the China Coast Guard asking us who we were, and now they seem to be headed our way.
The radio message was in English, and the crew couldn't understand it.
279, the speed of 10 feet.
They may not have understood the words, but the Coast Guard ship's movement was unmistakable. The captain of the Filipino boat decided to turn toward home. This is all happening inside the 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone of the Philippines. Despite the Filipino boat clearly moving away, China Coast Guard ship 5101 did not let it go, sailing to its left, then moving to its right, chasing the boat for an hour before it moved away. At this point, the Filipino vessel was 90 miles from mainland Palawan and sailing on a straight path home. But just as the China Coast Guard ship moved away, 2 new vessels appeared to continue the chase. They were smaller, but faster.
So the China Coast Guard ship, after a few minutes of chasing us down, made a turn and seemed to be leaving our path. But suddenly, at least 2 vessels from their direction came, and they're fast approaching us now. I can see at least 2 of the Hubei Type 22 missile fast attack craft that has been spotted and photographed stationed in Mischief Reef. But now they're far away from Mischief Reef and they seem to be chasing this boat.
These 2 boats have missiles mounted on them. They've been documented to be harboring at Mischief Reef, offering a new, faster kind of threat to the West Philippine Sea. The 2 missile boats split up, one on each side of the Filipino vessel. It tailed the Filipino boat for about half an hour before turning away as well, returning to the direction of Mischief Reef. While harassment, blockades, and chasing are no longer a new experience for Filipinos in the West Philippine Sea, prior to this, it has always been conducted by the China Coast Guard. Thursday was the first time that the news team experienced the Chinese Navy taking the lead role. And this could also be the very first time that the Type 22 missile attack craft have ever been documented used in the West Philippine Sea. Ayungin Shoal, where the boat wanted to go. Mischief Reef, where China's missile attack craft came from. And this Filipino boat are all inside the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines. We came out here to find out the conditions that Filipino fishermen need to face. We weren't expecting to experience it ourselves. Shara Zambrano, ABS-CBN News, Palawan.